Here we have a word problem that says the length of a rectangle is 2 more than 3 times its width. And they want us to find the dimensions of the rectangle if the perimeter around the rectangle is a total of 44 feet. So let's draw a picture, and pictures are always a great idea. If you can draw a picture for your word problem, they really tremendously help us understand the problem and think about what the variables are and think about how to write an equation using this information. So here it sounds like the length is a bigger number than the width, because the length is 2 more than 3 times the width. So it looks like the width would be the smaller value and the length would be the larger value here. And they want us to find the dimensions of the rectangle if the perimeter is 44 feet. So I know a formula for perimeter, so I guess we'll start there. I know that the perimeter of a rectangle is 2L plus 2W, right? 2L plus 2W. But that's got too many variables in it. I need to really, to solve this for one variable, I need to reduce these three variables down to just a single variable. Now, some things are obvious, like for instance, it says the perimeter is 44 feet. So right off the bat, I could take the P out and replace that with a 44. So that's good. But now notice they also give us some information that relates the length and the width to each other. For example, they say that the length is 2 more than 3 times the width. So whatever the width is, I think it's fair to say that the length is going to be, what did it say? It said 2 more than 3 times the width. So if we take 3 times the width and we add 2 to it, that should be the same as your length. And so what we can do here is, if you look over here in this equation, here's the length. And right now this equation has L's and W's, but if I notice that the length is the same as 3W plus 2, this is a very common thing. We can do a cut and paste. We can cut the L out and paste a 3W plus 2 in its place. So this is the same as 44 equals 2, I'll put a blank for the L for a minute, plus 2W. So this is 2L plus 2W, but what's the same thing as L based off of what the problem told us? L was 3W plus 2, of course. This is the same thing as L. Now this looks bigger. You might say, well, Devin, why would you prefer a bigger equation over a smaller equation? Well, I understand this is a little longer, but one big bonus to this equation is that it only has W's where the previous equation had L's and W's. And so if it just has a single variable and an exponent of 1 and all those good things, this yellow equation is a linear equation that I'm very good at solving. We've covered these for a number of videos now, how to solve linear equations. So from here, I think we can just go ahead with our natural steps of simplifying both sides, doing things like 6W plus 4 and then plus 2W equals 44. I see a few like terms. I've got a 2W and a 6W that can combine to be an 8W plus 4 equals 44. We can move the variables to one side and the constants to the other. The W's are already on the right, so we'll leave those on the right. So let's subtract 4 over to the left. And so we'd get 40 equals 8W. And then we'll divide both sides by the variable's coefficient of 8. And so W, the width, would equal 5. Okay, so that's great. But now we're tempted to just say, okay, well, that must be our answer. Let's go to the next problem because we got a solution. But you have to be really careful with these word problems to answer the question that they asked. And so here they wanted the dimensions of the rectangle. The dimensions is both the width and the length. So as long as we're clear on what order these are, let's just say it's width first and then length. What we just found was that the width was 5, and that's great, but now we also have to state what the length is in addition to the width. So how do we find the length if all we know currently is the width? Well, you can use any previous equation because all these equations are true. And so look on the screen here. Do you see any equation that would give us an L if we plugged in a W? Well, I see a couple. The main one I'm looking at is this one up here. Because notice if you plug in a W, it will provide you with the L that goes with it. So L would be 3 times 5 plus 2. 3 times 5 is 15. 15 and 2 makes 17. So the length would be 17. All right. Now the last thing we need to do is we've answered the question that they asked, but we also have to be careful with units. We can't just say 5 by 17 because 5 by 17 what? Inches? Miles? Pounds? I mean, what units are we using here? Well, you just scan the problem and it looks like all of our units were in feet. So the dimensions of our rectangle would be 5 feet by 17 feet. And it's important to have these units in here to help a reader understand or put into perspective just how wide and long this particular rectangle is. So anyways, we're finished with the problem. Just to recap, just the general overall approach that just so you can kind of see some consistency between different problems. You have your word problem. You identify your unknowns, preferably using a picture. You use those unknowns to write variables and write an equation that represents the problem. Once you have your equation written, you solve it. And when you're done, make sure to answer the question that you're being asked and be careful with the units that you're labeling in your answer.